Sohrab Ahmari is an editorial writer at the Wall Street Journal. He explained what's at stake in the battle for Fallujah.
I think the underlying political dysfunction in Iraq, of which this military failure is a symptom, hasn't been resolved, which is, you know, what is Iraq? Is it a multi-ethnic, multi-sectarian federal state that meets the needs of all of its component, or whether it's a Shiite state with pockets of Sunni and Kurdish resistance or separatism? That problem hasn't been resolved, and the military failures that you see are really a symptom of that deeper political crisis in Baghdad. And as long as that goes on, and especially if Sunnis don't feel safe and part of the system, they'll continue to have this sort of uprising and risk of radicalization and jihadists moving in. It's good, for example, that there is some Sunni tribal buy-in to this operation. It's good that the Iraqi Security Forces counterterrorism division is leading the battle, because it's the least sectarian unit of the Iraqi military. And it's very important that the Shiite militias stay at the outskirts of the city and not go in, because otherwise, you will have the same problem as you've had before, where these Shiite militias don't see themselves as a truth and reconciliation commission. For them, counterterrorism and counterinsurgency means drilling Sunnis in the skull with power tools. So in other words, they would go do house by house reprisal killings and so forth. So it's very crucial that the Iraqi central government and its Western allies hold back the Shiite militias and make sure that whatever comes afterward is a situation where Sunnis feel like they're bought in, they're invested, they're respected, and there's not a situation of reprisal killings. Otherwise, you'll have a humanitarian catastrophe, and then on top of that, you'll set the stage for more instability. Maybe it'll take a different name than Daesh, but it'll come back, as long as these people feel like they're not safe from Shiite militias.